You're listening to the Daily Sales Tips Podcast, and I'm your host, Scott Ingram. For today's tip, I asked Andrew Lassise to come back on. He previously shared tip number 96 last week about doing research on who you're pitching, and has obviously had a lot of success with that method, having grown Rush Tech Support to over $10 million in sales. The reason I asked him back was because he totally practiced what he is preaching here when he reached out to me, and it absolutely works, and not just with podcast hosts. Here he is.
And this is Andrew Lassise, and this is how to pitch a podcaster. Really, this works for anybody, but particularly, this is a very, very effective method that you can use to get on anybody's podcast, especially those that don't have gigantic followings. So this won't necessarily work for like the Tim Ferriss's and Joe Rogan's of the world, but the people just a notch below that, this will work perfect for them. So the first recommendation is listen to their podcast, know what they're interested in, because you don't want to be pitching something that they're not interested in. So what I suggest doing is listen to their trailer episode, listen to their first episode, because those episodes are when they are showing their true self, and then listen to their most recent episode, because things that may have been true when they started years ago may not necessarily be true anymore. So be sure to keep notes on the things that are similar across the episodes, and then be sure to hit on those when you're pitching them. So doing homework is a huge, huge part of it, because you want to be able to connect the dots to know exactly what they are looking for, and then touch on why you are exactly what they're looking for. So the notes that I take things on, I pay attention to what books they like, what motifs they live by. If it's something like the Jim Rohn, you're the average of the five people you surround yourself with most. Things like that are really important, because they're subtle little points that subconsciously, if someone says that to me, I automatically hear it and think, hey, they have a similar mindset to me. This person is the kind of person that I like and that I want to have on the show. So you want to try to find commonalities, and not just fabricated ones, but genuine similarities to their message and the message that you deliver. So then, because a lot of these people will be getting contacted by others, the way that you want to kind of go above and beyond, and I found this to be very, very successful, find them on social media and find out which one. Most people have one that they prefer over another. So find them on Facebook, on LinkedIn, on Instagram, on Twitter. Follow them on all of them. Add them as a friend. And then when you see the things that they're posting, start sharing those posts across all the platforms. They are going to see your name, especially if they're not a huge, huge name that gets hundreds, thousands of shares each time. If they only get a handful of shares, they're going to see that you are sharing their content. So you're providing value to them, and you're reaching out to your audience on their behalf. People like that. They'll take notice to you doing that. So share their posts, like their posts, add them as a friend. When you can make an introduction to them, send them a message. Not everybody gets sent messages. A lot of times people will just think, oh, well, they're too big. They don't even want to hear from me. And that may be true, but send it anyway. They'll at least get a little bleep and see your name again. Subscribe to their email list. And then when you get that first automated message, try replying to it. Some people, it's a no reply and they don't check it. Most people, though, do check it. And when you get a reply to your message, and it's just a thank you, hey, you provide value, just want to introduce myself, I'm into these topics as well, feel free to reach out. I've literally sent a link for people to be on my own podcast through that exact method, had them book themselves on the show. People that I thought were way out of my league, they just did it right there. I made it easy for them. They didn't have to go out of their way. They didn't have to research. I know that these people don't know who I am, but I'm still giving them the opportunity to get their message out on my platform. And my platform is very niched. And so I reach out to people that specifically target that niche, because I am providing the value that they want to have. And they know that I can reach people that they haven't reached yet, and vice versa. So we start that relationship. And then what I've discovered is a lot of times I have a guest on my podcast, and then they will have me on theirs. So not everybody has a podcast. Not everybody has that opportunity. But find something where you can help them. Know their pain points. Know the things that they may be running into. So as a podcaster, I know having a great guest that has poor audio quality is an absolute killer. They can still be providing value and have a great message, but it's just that little detail that it's just, I wish they weren't doing it on a cell phone. That would make it that much better. And I show them that you're not going to run into that issue with me. I'm comfortable in front of a camera. I'm comfortable on the microphone. You're not going to get the person that says, oh, sorry, I'm nervous, but they get into the flow. It's already happening. Another great way you can get on someone's podcast is reach out to guests who were on their show that maybe aren't quite as big, and then build a rapport with them. See if they can get you the introduction. You know that they are people who have access to them in some capacity, probably a lot more than you do. So even if there's a gatekeeper, they may have the direct connection that you're looking for. And so if you take all these tips, do your homework, and put it all together, you can get on 99% of podcasts just by doing a little extra homework, providing a little extra value. That's all you have to do.
Make sure you visit this tips page at dailysales.tips/102, where you'll find the tip in video form, as well as links to all things Andrew, including a link to his previous tip and his own self-made and sober podcast. And if you want to contribute your own tip to this show, you don't even have to do all that Andrew has suggested, although it certainly won't hurt. All you have to do is follow all of the instructions at dailysales.tips/submit. Thanks for listening, and be sure to come back tomorrow for another killer tip from Jeff Bajorek.